Do you ever feel like you're spending too much time on repetitive work? Replying to emails, writing meeting notes, or entering data? Hi, I'm Kevin, and today I'll show you how to use Lindy, a tool that automates those tasks so you could focus on what really matters, like, I don't know, baking cookies. Think of it as a digital coworker who never gets tired of the busy work. I partnered with Lindy to walk you through step-by-step how to build your very first AI assistant or agent in just a few minutes. The best part? No coding required, and you could try for free. Let's dive in. To get started, head over to Lindy's homepage. You'll find a link right here at the bottom of the screen. This link gives $20 in free Lindy credits. Right at the top, you'll see a button that says try for free. Click that and you'll be prompted to either sign up with a new account or sign in if you already have one. Go ahead and do that and I'll see you on the other side. Once you've signed in, you'll land on this homepage. Right in the center, you'll see the prompt that asks, "How can I help you?" This is where you tell Lindy what you'd like to automate. In this video, we're going to build an AI email assistant that automatically responds to questions in your inbox. And the best part, this is just one example. Once you've built your first agent, you'll see how easy it is to start automating just about anything. Right here, let's describe the agent that I want to create. I'll type in my text right here in this text field. Monitor my Gmail inbox for new incoming messages. If you can respond to the customer question based on information in a knowledge base, automatically respond to the customer question. If you don't know the answer, let the customer know, we'll follow up, and then notify me on Slack. You just describe what you want to automate in plain language, almost like you're talking to a coworker. And don't worry, it doesn't have to be perfect the first time. You can always come back and refine it later. And in fact, we'll do that. Let's now give it a try. In the bottom right, let's click here. It looks like it understands my request. Down below, let's now click on Build Agent. This brings us into the Flow Editor. And over on the left-hand side, we see what's called the Agent Builder. And this is what we're going to use to help put together our automation. If we scroll down, here it wants us to confirm that this is the agent that we would like to create. This aligns with what I typed in on the previous screen. So down below, I'll type in yes, and then let's send that. And there we go. The Agent Builder has created our assistant. Now, let's walk through the steps together. At the very top, you'll see what's called the trigger, email received. This is what tells the agent to wake up and start working whenever a new email arrives. Let's click into this step to have a look. This opens up a pane over on the right-hand side. And first off, you'll need to authorize it so Lindy has access to your email account, or in my case, my Gmail account. I've already done that. Now, down below, you can apply various filters. So that way, we're only looking at certain emails that come into your inbox. As an example, you can set up filters here. Maybe you only want to look at emails with certain text included in the body. You could set that up. Or down below, instead of looking at all emails, you could set it up to only external sending addresses or maybe just internal addresses. You have lots of control over here to define what emails you'd like to have trigger this workflow. I want to keep things simple, so I'll look at all emails. I'll make sure to select that right here. Next, let's look at the knowledge base by clicking into here. This opens up a prompt where we can add data to this agent's knowledge base. Basically, this is where we add the information the agent will use to respond to customer questions. You can include things like files, text, website URLs, and more. Now, let's click into text, and I'd like to include frequently asked questions from the Kevin Cookie Company, or our FAQ. I'll paste it in right here, and let's expand it so we can see the type of information that I'm adding. I'll add information like the store hours here, whether our cookies contain nuts, and if I scroll down, we even have information like how customers can get in contact with us, our phone, and our email address. Now, this all looks good, so down below, let's click on Add, and this is now adding that data to the knowledge base. Right down below, let's now click on Save. Over on the right-hand side, I see various settings that I can configure related to the knowledge base. Now, I'm good with all the defaults, so I'll leave them as is. Down at the very bottom, I can see the text file that I contributed to this knowledge base. The agent will now have access to this information and can draw from it when responding to customers. Of course, I can always go in and add additional knowledge if I want to give more information to the agent. However, for now, I think this works just fine. Let's now click into the next step, the condition. Here's how it works. If the agent finds an answer, or basically condition one, it'll automatically reply to the customer. If it doesn't, which is condition number two, it'll send the customer a quick email letting them know there's no answer yet, and then it pings me on Slack so I can step in. The best part is you can set all this up using plain language. No if-else statements or complicated logic. You just describe what you want, and then the agent takes care of the rest. Let's now click into the send email step. So assuming the agent has the information, let's see what happens here. When we click into the step, you'll see that it automatically generates the subject line and fills in the email body using AI. Here's the prompt that I'm feeding to the AI to respond to this customer message. Based on the customer's inquiry and the information found in our knowledge base, provide a helpful and comprehensive response to their question. You can modify this prompt if you like, but I think it works fine. There's no need to manually define each field, although you do have that control if you'd like it. As an example, here I could click in and set it to manual. However, I want to automate it with AI, so I'll leave it set to prompt AI. If we scroll all the way down to the bottom, you'll see a setting titled Save as Draft. This gives you a chance to review the message first, and once you're happy with it, you can send it off to the customer. I'll leave this set to off so it sends it out automatically. Let's now have a look at the other path if the agent does not have an answer. Over here, let's move over in the flow editor, and then let's click into this step where it emails the customer without an answer. Over in the right-hand pane, let's have a quick look at how this is set up. Here too, it uses AI to write a subject line and also to compose the body of the message. And here, the guidance is to thank the customer for reaching out and someone will follow up soon. Now, I think this looks good. So let's click into the last step, which is send direct message in Slack. Here too, you'll see that it automatically generates the content for the Slack message. You can always customize it if you'd like, but the default looks good for our needs. Everything looks set up correctly, so let's go ahead and test it out. First off, I'm going to send an email to my email address with a question that's contained in the FAQ. I've entered in my question, let's send it off. Back here within the flow editor, let's now test it out using that email message. In the top right-hand corner, let's click on test. Here it found the email that I just sent. Let's select this one for the test. Over in the flow editor, you can see the branch that it followed. This time it sent a helpful reply since it found an answer in the FAQ. Let's now check the inbox. Here I see the response and it includes the store hours. That's perfect. Let's now try a question that's not in the FAQ. Here's an email with another question. What's the world record for the fastest cookie dunk without breaking it? Now, I have no idea, but I would like to know the answer. Of course, this is not in the FAQ. Let's send that. Back within Lindy, in the top right-hand corner, click on test, and here I see my latest email question. Let's select that for the test. In this case, the agent does not find an answer, and here we can see the path that it followed. Instead, it sends the customer a follow-up email, and it also notifies me in Slack, just as we set it up to do. Here we can see the email response that the customer receives. That looks good. And here within Slack, I can see the notification that there's a customer question that my agent could not answer. So I'll need to step in to manually respond. If you'd like to keep modifying your agent, you don't have to rebuild everything from scratch. Back within the flow editor, let's once again open up the agent builder. Down on the bottom bar, let's click on this ask icon. And over on the left-hand side, here again, we see the agent builder. Now, you could simply type a message describing what you want to change or add, and Lindy will update the flow for you. It's a really quick way to refine your agent, whether you want to, let's say, add new conditions, maybe connect another app, or adjust how it responds. Let's take an example. I'd like to make a small improvement to the no answer found branch. Instead of just notifying the team on Slack and responding to the customer via email, I'd like to also log a ticket in HubSpot. That way, every unanswered email becomes a tracked support ticket. So over here, let me type in my message. Add an action to the no customer found path. I'd like to include HubSpot. Over here, let's now send that to the agent builder. Over on the right-hand side, I can see that it's now added a new step to create a ticket in HubSpot. When I click into it, of course, I'll need to connect my account first. Now, if you decide you no longer need a step, you could simply click into it and delete it. Right up here, I'll click on the three dots, and over here, let's click on delete. And there, we're back to the original flow.
Now that we've built and tested the agent, it's time to deploy it.
All you need to do is give your agent a name. In the top left-hand corner, you can click on this dropdown, and if you don't like the default name, over here, you could rename it. Now, in the top right-hand corner, let's click on the button that says Deploy. And just like that, this agent's now live. It'll automatically run in the background and handle incoming emails for you.
No extra work required. From here, you can always come back to the agent builder to make additional changes, maybe add some new actions, or monitor performance. But at this point, your AI assistant is officially live and ready to take work off of your plate. Once your agent's live, right on the top bar, let's click into the Tasks tab to see everything that it's been doing. Think of this as an activity feed. Every time your agent runs, it leaves a record here, and you can see a full history. You could open up any one of these tasks. As an example, I'll click into send email, and here I could see the exact email that it sent back to the customer. So you could see the inputs it received, the steps it followed, and the final output it produced. This is really useful to monitor your agent, make sure it's working as you expect it to, and even debug it if something doesn't look quite right. And one of my favorites, over time, it also gives you a clear view of how much repetitive work your agent is taking off your plate.
Before we wrap up in the workflow editor, there's one more feature you should know about: Autopilot. This gives your agent the ability to actually use a computer, unlocking almost any capability or integration you can imagine. With Autopilot, your agent can visit websites, log into accounts, make changes, and use tools and services just like you would. In other words, if you can do it on a computer, your agent can now do it too.
You can set this up in two different ways. Either include it in your initial instructions when building your agent, or you can add it later in the workflow editor. Here, as an example, I'm in the workflow editor. And right here, let's add a new step to perform an action. Here I see all the different action options. In the bottom right-hand corner, there's a category for by Lindy. Let's click on Lindy Computer and then select the action Start Computer. That adds a new computer, and then right down below, it also adds what's called an agent step. And right in the top right-hand corner, I can tell the agent what I want it to do on the computer. Let me know in the comments if you'd like to see a more in-depth tutorial on this. It's a super powerful feature and a major step toward having a true AI employee.
And that's it. You just built your first AI email assistant with Lindy. In just a few minutes, we went from signing in to creating an agent to deploying it live so you can manage your inbox automatically. But this is just a start. Lindy can do so much more, like schedule meetings, update your CRM, or send Slack notifications. If you click on New Agent and then Explore Templates, you'll find dozens of ready-made templates to spark some ideas. Once you've built one agent, it's easy to see how many other repetitive tasks you can now automate. If you'd like to try it out, head to the link in the description and you'll get $20 of free credits. And if this walkthrough was helpful, please give this video a like, subscribe to the channel, and check out my other tutorials on AI tools and productivity. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.